Good morning and welcome to Metropolitan State College of Denver and the 7th annual piano celebration. The theme of this year's piano celebration is Romancing the Keys. Two of the most famous romantic composers, and two of the most famous composers for the piano, Frédéric Chopin and Robert Schumann, were born. And in the classical music world, we like to celebrate major anniversaries, such as the 200th anniversary of their birth. That's the primary reason for celebrating romantic music on the keyboard in general, with particular homage to Chopin and Schumann. And the Romantic era really is probably the most significant, substantial era for piano music. Not only do we have Chopin and Schumann, we also have Beethoven, we also have Schubert, we also have Tchaikovsky. And so in the 1,000-year history of classical music, it's really the 19th century, the 1800s, that probably our richest repertoire of piano music comes down to us from.
I think to the audience, we need to occasionally be a little bit more relaxed, you know? Yeah. Because we're like on pins and needles through this whole song, and you're on pins and needles, right? So find some times that we can, you know, a little bit. And that might be some of these forte sections that could be a little bit more relaxed, both in your bodies and in the music.
Okay. Yeah, just feel the sound. Yeah. You know, you don't have to feel like you're holding the sound. Relax in the sound and let it come out.
Do you have an arrival in the piece?
This kind of ending section here.
More, go, more. Right. Okay, because you left me hanging there waiting for this, and really nothing came up. I mean, you gave me 30% because think, you know, this is such a spectacular moment. Yeah. I mean, the whole piece sort of goes to here.
Yeah.
And if you're not feeling emotionally connected,
It's one of those things where they rely upon you to create the action. And so it's like, well, what kind of action do you want? Oh, I want this to be glorious, and it's got to be fanfare-ish, and it's got to get this imposing scenery, the effect of that across. And basically, this is what you have. Here's a scene that demonstrates this. So that's the kind of thing you have to do. Thank you.
amorous love, Valentine's Day, that is romantic. That doesn't change the meaning of that. But realize that romanticism is a much larger concept. That embodies the irrationality of emotion as being both a good thing and a bad thing. It can make you sad, but it can make you blissfully happy, an all sort of range of emotions in between. And that is the true meaning of romanticism.